So on other Facebook tutorials, can I receive a request from the two users on how they can able to track their landing pages and their button? So yeah, let's get started. You need to go to your Facebook Ad Manager. So I'm gonna go to Ads Manager, and then you click the hamburger icon, and then go to the pixels. Then you want to make sure that your pixel is set up. So mine, I have already set up my pixel. It's already working. As you can see, it's already active. Now we will go into create a landing page. There's an example here. So I have made a test earlier and it is already working, but let me redo this one. So let's say this is my sales page, and let me change that slug URL. So let's make it gold giveaway, and then click the button. So I'm gonna remove that, and then my thank you page will be slash success. So this is this one, success. So my button would be purchase now. Let's say it's purchase now, and then this is, let's say, purchase $49 instead of 100. So it's just something like that. And then let me just change that into gold discount, so it's portioned to our sales page. Now if you click that sales page, this is the sales page that we have as an example. Now we can track the sales page by clicking the create custom conversion, and then you will be asked what URL you would like to track. So I will track the gold discount page. Then you will rename it what kind of conversion it is. So let's say gold package purchase, or make it brief as possible. So the category would be purchase. And then the value, how much would that be? Let's say it's $49. $49, and then create. And then done. Now we will going to test that. Click the test events, and then you need to enter the sales page, which is this, and open. Okay, and let's see if it is working. I will refresh that, and okay, see if it is working. As you can see here, I just clicked the test event, and you will see that the purchase gold is working. So the pixel was able to track the conversion. Now the second concern from our user is he wanted to track his button. So here, as my example, I have a button called purchase now. So edit page, and this is how it looks. Now we will need to create a event. So click the setup and then set up new events. Now I will prefer to use the manually add event code, and then you need to choose what kind of event it is. So just choose the closer name as much as possible. So I'm gonna select purchase, and then event, track event on inline action. We will not use this because this is just, it's tracking every time the page is loaded, and this should not be the case. We want to track the action. So the conversion value, let's say again $49, and then the currency $49, and then the content or quantity, say 1, and then value 49, and then ID would be it's a gold package. And then actually you can just, let's just get this cart ID there and put it on our button. Put it into button ID equals the ID. Now is this is basically holding the ID of our event. So I'm gonna update that sales page. Now we already have a working button, but we need to get that script. We need to get this script and put it into our success page, or we call it we call that thank you page. So I'm gonna go back there. So pages and then success. So I will remove that because that is a different event. So thank you for purchasing the gold package. Now you need to remove this insert event code and paste this, put it there. Make sure you remove the script and the script at the end, and then update. Now we already have a working conversion page, and it's time to track this one. So done, already, it's already working. Click the settings, settings, and then open the event setup tool. Now we will need to paste the sales page, which is the gold hyphen discount, then open that. And then you will be asked for confirmation from the event setup tools what you would like to track. So I'm going to track the button and then click that one, and what kind of event it is. It's obviously purchase and the value. So I'll just click the don't include value, then confirm. Now we already have it's, I just click the finish setup, then finish. Okay. Now we already have a working event. I will open this one in incognito mode and then click the purchase. So we're already in the success page. Now let's go back to our event manager and see if it is truck. Okay, go back there. Let's see if it is truck. So you can see here, this is the event action. It was successfully tracked. It's gold purchase. I hope this has been helpful, and if you have any questions on Pixel or any videos you want me to record, just comment down below and I will answer as much as possible. Have a great day, and please don't forget to click the subscribe button to receive notification from me. Thank you.